Omar Lutfi here with Lutfi Innovations. Today I'm going to be installing my mini split system, and I thought I'd show everyone what boxes came with the system and what I bought. So the three boxes in the front are the main unit. You can see the front got banged up a little bit, but it looks like it's just the styrofoam, so I think we're okay there. And behind the three boxes, I bought the PVC kit to cover up the lines on the outside and a mounting bracket to mount it onto the wall of the basement. So we'll see how things go from here. All right, here is everything out of the box. Here's the inverter and everything that came in that box. And here's the compressor. And here's the contents of the third box with the copper tubing and wiring. And here's everything that came in the PVC kit. And this is the hardware for the mounting bracket. So everything looks like it's in good shape, and I'll see what I can do with all this. Okay, here we've mounted the bracket on the wall. I had a little trouble finding the studs because of how the wall was built, but we got it in there eventually. All right. This is not what you want to see when you drill a hole into the wall. So looks like we're going to try and move it down a couple inches, and hopefully that this hole will be still covered by the unit. So back to mounting the bracket. All right, now here I put the wiring in on the front panel, and the cover was a little difficult to get off, but I managed to get it out without breaking it, so mission accomplished. All right, so here I am outside my house, and I just drilled the hole, and you can see I've got the two copper lines and the electrical and the drainage pipe. I've just kind of hand tightened these, and come down here. I've also drilled a hole into my basement, and I'm feeding those in as we speak. And surprisingly, this was, I thought, going to be the hardest part of the project, and it turned out to go most smooth. So we'll go down in the basement next. All right, I got my copper tubes hooked up, and I'm currently working. I just ran the vacuum pump, so the vacuum ran from the unit to my gauge, which is, I ran it for about half an hour. That's kind of where it's staying, to the vacuum pump, and it doesn't seem to be moving anymore. And this is just how I'm gonna do it. I've seen it done a lot of different ways online, and maybe not the best in the world, but this is how I'm doing it. So next step, release the Freon. All right, to be honest, I forgot to video the Freon release, but basically I had the vacuum tubes in here, and I unscrewed these caps and stuck the Allen wrench in here and slowly released the Freon, and it just made a whoosh noise. And then I unscrewed the vacuum and it made a psh noise, and that was it. All right, I'm doing a little follow-up here. This is my PVC pipe that I put around the copper tubing and the drainage pipe. You can see it starts at the top and goes down to the bottom, and here's where it goes into the basement. As you can see, I haven't 100% finished that, but I still have to decide exactly how I want to do that bottom part, but 99% finished. All right, so if you're watching this, you're probably wondering, why did I mount the compressor in the basement? Well, the whole key of this is that the basement is always 50 degrees, so in the summertime, instead of trying to pull heat
push heat into 100 degree air, you're starting with 55 degree air, and in the winter time, you have the same situation where you're only trying to heat 50 degree air. So this is indirectly a geothermal system or a ground source heat pump without the cost. So will it work? I don't know. It seems to be running fine, and I'll just collect some data and see how it runs, and I'll make some more videos. But so that about wraps it up for installing the mini split with the compressor in the basement. Thanks.